What sort of PC can you build for $1,000 for Star Citizen? That is what this video is about. At the end as well, I've given a few thoughts on what you'd spend more money on if you had more than $1,000, but it's pretty interesting. We've been on Newegg, let's get into it. So here we go. We're on Newegg, we're in the US. The majority of people who watch this channel are in America, so we're gonna do it in dollars. You'll see immediately that we failed to hit the 1,000 mark, but there's a few reasons for that, and you could make this work. First off, starting with the case, we've gone fairly bit more expensive than you probably need to, because I think airflow and having a decent case is fairly important. I would recommend highly checking out the Gamers Nexus series on cases. It's a brilliant YouTube channel, and I think they've got the best case reviews and just give you really good information. But yes, I actually own a version of this case, and it's got good airflow, and in some ways there's no point having a load of great components in your PC if they're too hot to actually run at their top speed. So I like a decent case. The same with a power supply. Don't really want to cheap out on a power supply. We're going to just take this top one here, the bestseller. It's plenty of capacity, 750 watts and a decent Corsair series. You don't need that much necessarily for this build, but having had to upgrade my power supply when I got the 3080 that's in my main system, I think probably just having the headroom and making sure you've got plenty is a good idea. There are rumors that the next Nvidia series of graphics cards are going to be even more power hungry, and so that might change the situation a bit, but for most people I think 750 watts will be plenty. Then obviously our main thing is the CPU for Star Citizen. For Star Citizen performance, if you're here, you've got no idea, you've not watched any other videos, Star Citizen is basically bottlenecked by the CPU in majority of the areas. So Old Lake, the newest series from Intel, is the best bet for Star Citizen performance. Now, this 12400F is a 6-core, 12-thread part. Doesn't have any of the efficiency cores, but it should be fairly decent. It doesn't clock as high as the K version, and you've also obviously got the i7 or the i9, but for this budget you're probably looking at this as being your best bet. It should be pretty decent for Star Citizen. Then obviously you need a motherboard that's compatible. There is an argument to say that you could go for the B660 chipset here and lose overclocking capabilities for the CPU and lose a bit of connectivity and a bit of I think you lose some PCIe lanes in that on that chipset. So that would save you money, but I think I tend to, a bit like with the power supply, want to choose a motherboard that's got everything I'm gonna need and gonna potentially need over the next few years. So the 690 chipset gives you overclocking. So if you do then want to put in a K CPU, you can overclock it. So I think I'd probably go with this, just then I've got everything on this platform that I need. So I've chosen this one here. It's not the cheapest. I've got a couple of these. I've got the DDR4 and the DDR5 versions, and it's a good motherboard. I think Hardware Unboxed do very good VRM temp comparisons for motherboards. So again, that's another YouTube channel to check out for motherboards in this sort of series. So we'll go for that, $200, but again, you could save a few if you wanted to. Next one, RAM, just a generic really, 16 gigs, 3600 CL16. We're doing 16 gigabytes for this build, but one of the first upgrades, if you had a bit more money, would be probably to go 32 gigs for Star Citizen. Then the final piece of the puzzle is obviously our graphics card. And as we've been saying for a while now, if you've got an older graphics card that's half decent, probably stick with that for now. But if you are coming into this wanting to buy everything new, you've not got anything else, your best bet is going to be the RX 6600. It's not a great graphics card. You're probably going to be, most definitely going to be targeting 1080p, and it's really overpriced for what it is, but it's probably your best bet. And if you compare it to the options really on the secondhand market, you switch over to eBay, you are looking really at a 2060 KO is a bit quicker probably, and the 2060 Super is a bit quicker, but the 2060 is probably around it and a bit slower at various points. That price there, and these are all sold ones that have already gone, it's a bit less, but obviously it's a used card, and in some games the 2060 isn't as good. So this is complicated. Graphics cards are a bit of a nightmare to choose from, but yeah, really if you can avoid it, you wouldn't want to buy one. As I came to edit this, I realized I'd completely forgotten storage. So here's just a quick look. It's going to add a little bit onto the price, but we've got just a standard solid state drive is what you need. SSD, SATA solid state drive. You don't need anything to do with M.2. It makes no difference to performance, and it makes very, very little difference to load time. So I would suggest just getting a decently branded solid state drive. 500 gigs we're going for here. In theory, you could go smaller, but yeah, if you're going to use the PC for anything else, yeah, I'd go with this. Probably this Kusha one here does the job. $52. So here is the shopping cart. And again, we've gone over our budget. You could save money on this. You could save money on this. You could save money probably on the RAM actually as well. And you definitely save money on the case. So you could get it to £1,000. You obviously need $1,000, sorry. You could make it closer to that. But yeah, I mean, and then let's just talk about if you've got more money. If you've got more money, the obvious thing to upgrade wouldn't probably be, I wouldn't necessarily start with the graphics card. I'd probably look at getting maybe either a slightly higher clocking version of the i5, or if you've got a fair bit more money, I'd then jump up to the i7, which has got a bit, it's got 8 cores and 12 and 16 threads. And some versions, the K version, I think will have, in fact, I think all of them have got E cores as well, the efficiency cores. So it'll have more multi-threading capacity. And with Star Citizen, we're waiting for the Gen 12 renderer and Vulkan to allow our CPUs to be fully utilized. So there is a case to say that the i7 is a better long-term bet than the i5. It's got more cores, it might be a bit better option. The other thing to upgrade would probably be jumping to 32 gigs of RAM for Star Citizen. It does use regularly more than 16 gigs, and the game does work at 16 gigs, but the performance is generally smoother. You don't really get more frames with 32 gigs, but you get less hitches and all sorts of stuff to do with the page file that's going on. So that probably would be the other thing. So that would be the CPU and the RAM would be the things that if you suddenly want to go closer to 1,500, then they'd be the things that I'd be looking to upgrade. And then also, if you've got loads more money and you just have to have, if you're targeting at 1440p, for instance, you're going to have to go higher on the graphics card. But again, really, you don't want to do that right now. So there you go, my rough $1,000 PC build for Star Citizen. Again, this is rough. I wouldn't go out and buy that exact shopping cart. There's probably reviews out there that will help you work out which motherboard and which RAM. And there's also a case to say, if you don't want to go Intel, you could go with AMD and get a maybe B450 motherboard and the 5600X for your CPU, and you'd probably save a bit of money there. Performance wouldn't probably be quite as good as it is with the older Lake CPUs, but it wouldn't be far off. So there's different options. The main problem, as we always mention, is the GPU. It's just not a good time to be buying a GPU. And for the game itself, Star Citizen, you could argue that really now isn't the right time to buy a computer for the game itself. And also with the parts that are about to come out over the next year, the CPUs that are going to come out over the next year, or the GPUs that are going to come out over the next year, you could definitely make an argument to wait and not spend $1,000 now. But the video is here just for anybody who's absolutely desperate to get into it, and just for people who are interested to see what can you get through $1,000. So there you go. Like, subscribe, join the Discord for chat about all this sort of stuff, and become a channel member. And that's enough for this one. I'll see you soon. Bye.